another day in Namibia. It's 9:30, 27 degrees. It's actually quite pleasant. It's not too hot. I've got around 90 kilometers today to this lovely little spot surrounded by mountains, so I'll be camping there. We are now getting closer. We got 12 kilometers left. Okay. Yep, it already looks pretty. But we are getting closer, so I'll be camping somewhere there in these mountains, well, surrounded by mountains. This is so beautiful, isn't it? Wow. Absolutely epic. There's campsite here and campsite there, so which way I should go? Okay, let's go to this one. Hello. Is there reception there, further?
Yeah,
there
is.
Thank you. Hello.
Hello.
How are you going?
Good, good. How are you?
Not too bad, thank you.
Welcome.
I wanted to ask you about your campground. Are you allowed to camp near the rocks?
Yes.
Oh, cool.
There are campsites all the way around.
Okay, so is this the campsite that's got the best view?
Yes.
Okay, now I'm in a good place, yeah?
Yes, right there.
Okay, so what do we got here? Here's restaurant. Okay. And then I'm supposed to, I think, go this way. That's actually quite long distance from the restaurant. Village. I'm now following a manager of this campground. He said I'll be able to camp in sort of like a cave. So let's see. Like there? That's so cool. It's like opening, hey?
Yeah. This one, then in the back there's a nice one where you
I was actually thinking about setting up that tent here, but this is perfect. Glad I came across Andre, who showed me this cave. I mean, I love camping, but if there is opportunity of me not setting up my tent and sleep in this sort of scenario, you have no idea. Outside, super hot. Here, so much cooler. Place for the sleep tonight. Half of the cave, I think, because you do have opening. I mean, how cool is this? What's the chance? Luxury sleeping for me. Thank you for that. That's awesome. That's perfect. Nice. Thank you so much. We are going now to this. It's like a tourist attraction here, right?
Yeah, it's one of the Bushman paintings.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Chains, where you walk up a chain for about 100 meters. It's a little bit of climbing, okay. But there's a chain to help you up.
Okay.
And then you get to the Bushman paintings on top with a nice scenic view as well.
So this is the chain, eh? That's quite steep, isn't it?
No, it's not steep.
I think so.
No.
It's not steep? Hello, are you my tour guide?
Mm-hmm.
Nice to meet you, Kinga.
Mackenzie.
Nice to meet you, Mackenzie. Do you mind if I'll be recording you?
Mm-hmm.
You don't mind?
You can record it.
Okay, thank you. Mm. Okay, so let's start the tour.
Let's start the tour.
Okay, wait for me.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Are you going to go all the way up with me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so this is for weak people like me, yeah?
Mm-hmm. To help yourself.
Do you use it?
Sometimes, some parts.
Are we there yet? Are we halfway at least? Just a second. I need to drink water. Alright, we're nearly there.
Mm-hmm.
Nearly. But yet, not at the top. So this is our little stop and then we're gonna see the paintings, yeah?
Exactly.
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 Whew. That is a bit of a challenge and for me and my condition. But you're doing fine. I'm very impressed. Very
exactly.
Fine.
Exactly.
Wow, what's that? Big hole. What caused it, do you know?
So, in the past, people was digging the minerals here.
Yeah.
Mm, so that's those are the white crystals.
Uh-huh.
And these are black tourmalines.
Right.
Mm, so they dig it and sell it next to the gravel roads.
Uh-huh.
So they get some money.
Sure. So this is just old hole that someone dug.
Exactly. But now it's forbidden to dig here in the park.
Sure. at the paintings?
We are now here at the pool. Okay. So welcome to Bushman Paradise.
Thank you.
So these are the paintings done by Bushman people.
How old are they?
So these paintings are here for 2,000 to 4,000 years old.
Wow. Do you know what pigment they used back then?
Exactly. So they use the stone that we call an ochre stone. That himbas
use it for the skin.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So they crush it, mix it with the animal blood and an ostrich egg, but the yellow one. Then they draw their paintings in the safe places. Mm-hmm. So water cannot damage it away. So that's how Bushman peoples was communicating on their rocks. Mm-hmm. It was like a message. Giraffe following black rhino.
Right. Right, time to go back.
Time to go back.
Okay, hopefully it won't be as tiring as going up. All right, when you're recording and you're trying to go, maybe it's not such a good idea. Leader, we made it. No one got injured. That was very nice. Thank you so much for this tour.
You are welcome.
Thank you. And now where are we going?
Small Bushman Paradise.
Small Bushman Paradise. Yeah. So we're going to some Bushman paintings as well?
Yes, also much smaller. And not the big hike up to the top again.
Good.
Just a small walk.
What was your name again?
Gideon.
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 Gideon. Gideon. Okay. So where are we now?
So we are now at Small Bushman Paradise.
Okay. Ta-da.
So these are the paintings done by a small group known as the Bushmen. Bushmen. So Bushmen are hunters and gatherers. So women and children, they would collect wild fruits as well as the wild medicine while the men would do the hunting. Mm-hmm. But the actual reason why Bushmen have drawn the paintings, it was a way of communication.
What's this?
So here we have got two crawling Bushmen. So we have got two
crawling Bushmen. That's human. So
they would
and rhino.
Wear the skin of the animal, trophy head. And once they get the close range from the edge, running ostrich. And here we have got the whole group
of humans,
Bushmen heading to their next destination. So Bushmen are nomads and they don't stay on the same place for a very longer period of time. Mm. Animals follow the rain. Underneath the zebra, that's the whole group of Bushmen doing their traditional dance called trance dance. Mm. So trance dance, it's a ritual dance.
So now we're going to the bridge, right?
Yes.
Well-known bridge. Hold on, bit by bit. This is so cool. That is like a frame, isn't it? Isn't it like a picture frame? Morning, how's my hair? Bit bad, eh? My night at the cave was excellent. I could actually see some stars from above. It's very early at the moment, it's around 6 o'clock. I'm packed up and good to go. I got up very early because I want to witness the beautiful sunset. So hopefully I'll be able to fly my drone because I don't think it's windy at the moment. So let's do it. I'm gonna wander around a bit because I've got very nice lightning and I want to take some pictures of Chile. So let's see how that's gonna go. Ooh. There we go, these two. Wow. Maybe somewhere here I'll stop. Maybe, yes. An epic place. It was just—it's just so photogenic, so stunning, beautiful. Right. So now I'm heading back to Wolfish Bay, where I'll be staying with some friends. You know, it's right now. It's time to do laundry, have a shower, that sort of stuff, and just have some nice time with my friends. This road, I'm telling you, it's like variegations mixed with sand and bull dust. And every now and then you get a nice soft patch, and then mess again. We'll be right back.